Hi everyone, Lloyd Rieber here again. This time I have a graphics tablet and I would like to use it to try to help explain a little bit better what the normal curve or a normal distribution is all about. So a normal curve is really just a graph of some data. So to create a good graph, I need to have axes, the x and the y axis. So I'm going to draw that out, and we need to label these axes. So if I'm giving a typical, you know, test of some sort, a pretest or a post-test, we would call the x-axis, maybe scores, and the y-axis should be labeled frequency. And let's continue to label this. So what's the range of scores? Well, let's just say it's a typical kind of test where 100 is the maximum, 0 is the minimum. And so this would be 50, and that would be about 75. So one way to make sense out of this would be, let's say I give the test, and I, you know, grade the test, and I start taking a look at all the scores, and I want to start charting those scores. So I take a look at the first one, and it turns out that the person got a 75. So I'll just put an X right there. Next person got a 98. I'll put an X there. Next person got a 60. I'll put an X there. Next person got another 75. So I'll just stack the X's on top of one another. So again, I'm just looking at the scores one by one. That person got a 50, this person got an 80, and pretty soon, after a period of time, you start seeing something like this. And of course, this is all hypothetical. You probably see where I'm going with this. And maybe for a short time I get something like this, but with enough scores, if the distribution is normally distributed, I am going to get a shape that is going to resemble a bell. So how many scores do I have here at the 75? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So if I come over here to the y-axis, that's where I would label the 7. And indeed, if I go, it would be right there. So this looks to be about 3 right there. And so as I go over, I would see a total number of 3 scores at that particular height. And with enough scores, I begin to get this curve that we all know so well. And if it is normally distributed, the 75 would be the mean, and the median, and the mode. So if I were to add up all those scores, divide by how many there are, I would get 75. If I would line up all those scores in a row and take the middle number, it would be the median. And as you can plainly see here, the most popular score is going to be the highest on the curve, which is also would be the mode. Okay, well, let's do this again, and this time we'll take a slightly different strategy. Okay, this time I actually have a set of numbers here all in a row from 100 down to 70 ready for us to use. And to me, this is a very concrete way of getting to know your data and understanding how the data are distributed. It's very similar to what we just did, but instead of laying it out first on the on a graph, to actually go and lay out your scores, and as you look at the scores one by one, you start to see where they appear. So let's say the first score was a 90, to put just a tick mark at that particular case. And we could continue to do this just like we were doing with the X's, and this time we'll, in our own heads, realize that 85 is going to be the average of this set of scores. But again, I would not know that until I actually begin to take a look at the data. So same idea as before, but a very concrete way to understand how the data are distributed. Now, again, you know where I'm going with this. And now, to make the case even clearer, if I were to take those scores and just rotate them, as you see here, I again can easily see the distribution being normally distributed. And in this case, we see that 85 is going to be the mean, median, and the mode. So it's very important to know your data, and I think graphing the data is one of the best ways to do this. And let me finish this video with some really fast examples of what of how important this is. For example, here you have a set of scores, and as you look at that, you might say, well, you know, what to make of them. And until you graph it, it's really hard to tell that it turns out this is a very skewed distribution. So I have this handy dandy Excel program that will draw the distribution for me, and here you see the output of this particular set of data, and I'll share this Excel program with you, but you can clearly see how this set of data are skewed in a certain direction. This would be a negatively skewed distribution where the tail is going toward the left and the scores are rather all bunched together on the right. Now, in a skewed distribution, the mean, median, and mode are not going to be the same value. Let me choose a different color here. I always like to start with the mode because it's so easy to find. The mode is going to be the highest point. So this point right there looks to be about 95. That is the mode. It turns out in this particular set of data, the mean is just about 90. So there's the mean. And the median will be in between, right about there. Let me share another set of scores with you. I'll make it a little bit bigger so you can see. And again, just eyeballing these numbers, it's rather hard to tell. So let's graph these out using my Excel tool to do it. And here it is. As you can see, this particular data is clearly normally distributed. Now let's compare that with another set of numbers. And again, just eyeballing those numbers, I think you will agree it's very difficult to tell what kind of distribution we have. Well, let's take a look at that distribution. And here it is. A very different distribution. This would be called a bimodal distribution because you really have two modes. But the other interesting thing is the average of these two distributions is almost exactly the same. Again, until you actually graph these out or perform very special calculations, you can be very much misled just by computing some measure of central tendency such as a mean. Well, I hope this little video has helped to demystify the normal distribution for you a little bit and helps you to understand where it comes from. This is very important because so many of the statistics we're going to be calculating depend or rest on the assumption that your data are normally distributed. Okay, until next time.